It may interest you to note that the projects you have been doing in this class are based on cutting-edge research. Until just a few years back, all computational models of solving problems from the Raven's test first extracted propositional representations from the figures and then ran propositional engines on those propositional representations. Thus, they may extract the transformation from A to B in the form of a semantic network shown here. And similarly, they may extract the transformation from C to 5 through the semantic network shown here. They would then compare these two semantic networks and decide whether or not A's to B is similar to C's to 5. You may have done something similar in your early projects. But in 2012, Mathli Kunda, here at Georgia Tech, was able to write a computer program that used only analogical representations without extracting any propositional representations and yet were able to solve problems on the Raven's progressive matrices test. It used only affine and set transformations over the analogical representations. So as an example, it would compare A and B by saying that it is a set transformation, this particular dot is no longer there. And there is affine transformation, in fact, two affine transformations. First, that make this square bigger, and second, that translates the position of the square from inside the circle to outside the circle. It would find similar affine and set transformations that would relate C and 5, that will compare the affine and set transformations, again, without extracting any propositional representations. Little surprisingly, Mathli Kunda's program called ASTI, for A-S-T-I, was able to do quite well in the Raven's test. It solved 50 out of the 60 problems correctly. Then in 2013, Keith McGregor, again here at Georgia Tech, wrote another computer program that used a different kind of analogical representation called the fractal representation. And he was able to show that the fractal representation also enables addressing problems on the Raven's test with a good degree of accuracy. We provide references both Mathli's work and Keith's work in the notes.